നമസ്കാരം എവറി വൺ ആൻഡ് വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക് ടു എൻ എപ്പിസോഡ് വിത്ത് ഓംകാർ അണ്ണ. നമസ്കാരം അണ്ണ.
നമസ്കാരം വൈഷു, ഹൗ ആർ യു?
ഐ എം ഗുഡ്. സോ ഓംകാർ അണ്ണ ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് ഹട്ട് യോഗ ഇൻ താനെ. സോ ഇഫ് യു വോണ്ട് ടു റീച്ച് ഔട്ട് ടു ഹിം, പ്ലീസ് ടു മെസ്സേജ് ഹിം ഓൺ ഹിസ് ഇൻസ്റ്റാഗ്രാം. സോ സോ അണ്ണ, ലൈക് റീസെന്റ് യു മെസ്സേജ് മീ ദാറ്റ് യു ഹാവ് സ്റ്റോപ്ഡ് ബിലീവിംഗ് ഇൻ സദ്ഗുരു. വൈ ഇസ് ദാറ്റ്?
So yes, I have stopped believing in Sadhguru. See, when I started, even when I started, I was not a believer in anything because staying in India, it was so difficult to believe in any of the Babas, if you say in general, right? Because there was fraud everywhere. But first time I saw Sadhguru, I did not feel as if, I felt something different. I felt he is not the same kind. And then when I saw him in Canada, it was totally different, right? And the way he spoke, everything felt very logical. So whatever he felt, whatever logically I could accept, I started accepting it. And then a point came where we started experimenting the same thing with the sadhana, and the sadhana started working. And then a small belief came where, okay, let me try the belief first to try the sadhana. Whatever he says, okay, it makes sense, and let me try that sadhana. And okay, then the belief was only for that reason. And then whatever lessons that we took from him, it was about accepting and all the other things. But then when the difficult situation comes, it gets very difficult to digest it, right? It is very difficult. It's very hard to accept when very, very difficult situation comes. As the previous time you asked me, like, how can, you know, but when we are dealing with the outer world, how to take care of all these things, right? So this is what Sadhguru is actually telling us. So he doesn't want, he like from the beginning he says that you don't have to believe in me. So this is the one thing with the sadhana that happened, is a state came where even I was very much confused and frustrated. Whenever it is not so difficult, the situations are not so difficult, I was able to accept things, looking at it logically, looking at outward, okay, it's their freedom, let me give them their freedom, or what, okay, this is how it is. A point came where, you know, when I went for the training, and before the training, it was all volunteering and full involvement. And after the training, some things were there. I had to get back to my work, and because I was staying in abroad, it was difficult as well. So monetary wise also, and other aspects also, there were some other things that were troubling me. I was like, whether should I get involved in it or whether should I not get involved in it? Whether should I allow them to be the way they are, or whether should I stop them because they are not doing it? Whether should I force people to do sadhana, or whether should I just leave them on their own? So this confusion was there. And then because over there the people were still sane enough, I feel like they are all organized, they won't disturb you so much. Then when I came back to India, it was like, okay, now in India people are very smart, so I also have to be smart. So this thing came to me, and again that outward way, I want to tell them, I want to, you know, then accepting became difficult, as you were saying, how when dealing with the outer world, how can you actually manage it? So then you try to look at Sadhguru's words, but also you try to have this limited mind where, you know, it tells you, it gives you that limitation, that fear, that no, maybe somebody will misuse you, or somebody will do something wrong to you, so I also have to be smart. Then I don't have to be a good person. Then I started looking at it like, I don't have to be a good person. So that was a different, I perceived it in a different way, I would feel. Okay. And then a point came where I felt, okay, I should not interfere in anybody's life. The few people, they told me that, you know, it's best not to interfere in their life, because it is like you are forcing them, you are telling them. So then I felt, okay, let me not interfere. It's their life, their karma, you know. So, and this my life, my karma also, it was like at a very difficult situation, I used to feel, oh, it's my life, my karma, I have to suffer it. All right. And so this was my thinking that happened. As I told you, right, a point came where I felt little, like a difficult situation came where I felt very uncomfortable, and I'm looking at everything that is happening around the world. So that time I felt, okay, my life, my karma, I have to accept it. It was very difficult. But then I intensified my sadhana, and a state came where something within me just blasted. And a state came, this was in my asanas, that time I started doing my Bhairavi sadhana. It's all after that Bhairavi sadhana started when Sadhguru opened that up for us. And the 11 times, 33 times I have done, like, just said, okay, I'll do the maximum as best as I can. And after that, it just came within me that, okay, like, me and this universe, you know, it's not different. It's just the same experience. It's what is here is there as well. So it that I just touched that experience within me. And from then onwards, I started looking at life. I started understanding life, everything. I started looking at it. Why is it happening? Why is this happening? That outward action went down, inward action. So it actually it goes from here to there. But for me, it came from there to down. So I touched that within me first, and then I started looking inward. That okay, what it is? Like, it's not the other person. It is only a situation. It is only a situation that is happening. Then I started seeing the word, okay, it's only an individual that Sadhguru says that if you can, it's only you and me. If you can transform me, that yourself, then you can transform the entire world. This something it became very true to me because I always wanted to do something for others. I was always in this dilemma that whether should I tell them or should I not tell them. Then when I look at it from today's point of perspective, it is my thing. I'm trying to put it on them, right? The same thing which Sadhguru asks us not to do. Let's see, whenever we do any sadhana or anything, we think, okay, it is working for me. Other person also should do it. If he is not doing it, he is doing it wrong. He is wrong. So what, as Sadhguru says, nothing is right and wrong. So it is my limitation where once again, I am trying to force my things on them. So these things all started becoming true in my experience where if I become the change, then only things around me will also change. Then only things around me can also differ. So these things and whatever Sadhguru says, right, whatever he says, now I was not only believing it, but it was coming from within me. It was becoming true from within. Now anything that becomes true for you, right, then it is you cannot ever deny it. Yes, sir. So if you see me flying, if anybody says no, I cannot fly, first of all. But if you see me flying, but if anybody says no, you still know what is the reality. Okay, he can fly. Maybe I was a bird, let's say, for example. So same thing. Maybe I'm talking on the phone right now. You cannot deny that. But 1,000 years ago, anybody will easily deny you and they can even kill you because you are saying something wrong. You're trying to fool the world. So the same thing, if it comes from within you, it becomes very easy to accept it. So that's the reason I said that I have stopped believing in Sadhguru because now those things have become true for me. It's coming from within also. So it's not so difficult to digest it. And this is where Sadhguru wants all of us to reach, that he wants us to reach a state that we are not only believing it, but we are experiencing that within us. Yes. So that's the reason I just as a provoking thing, I said that I have stopped believing in Sadhguru. So yes, that's all I wanted to share, and it's a possibility. I never expected this because my only aim was to reach out the world as much as I could till my last breath I could teach. As I started for the health and well-being of the people, never knew what is spirituality. When I came in, I started experiencing some energy things, but still I did not know what it means. There were some people, like even Vandana, she mentioned once that in BSP she experienced herself in everyone, energy wise. She just felt it. Okay, I felt okay. Maybe after listening to Sadhguru, I felt okay, it's a possibility. Earlier, if anybody could ask me who you are, I would say I'm Omkar. What's wrong with you? But now that question, who I am, it is, I feel okay. It's an important question that everybody should ask themselves, like, where is it coming from? So if we start paying attention towards everything, if we do our sadhana, then this possibility is there. I'm not yet enlightened, but definitely I've touched a possibility where I cannot deny it now. And where I cannot deny the fact, even if I blame on somebody, I look like a fool to myself. I am not yet moment to moment, but at least the next moment I know what I am doing. Maybe it was an outward act. It was an outward action, not maybe. It was an outward action. So I try to look within myself. And I believe that's the way to go forward and for the growth.
Awesome, Anna. So thank you so much. So where can people reach out to you, and where can they find their find your programs happening?
Yes, so usually I do my po we do the posting on the Facebook, and with the help of Vaishu, we share it on your YouTube channel and the Instagram as well. So you can find us over here and the Facebook as well and the Instagram
Can you
and
just
all the
mention your
program.
Instagram? Can you just verbally mention it?
It is Umi Kamat. I mostly am not on Instagram. I'm on Facebook. So through your channel only they can find it in the community section, I guess, like whenever you post it or on your Instagram. So if you cannot find me, you can find Vaishu. He is the boss of I guess social
You
media.
can tell me, I
And
will say yes.
yes. And then in the flyer itself, you have my number also. So on the WhatsApp is the best way to contact me.
Awesome, Anna. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Namaskaram.
Thank you, Vaishu, for giving me this platform to share it. See, earlier, whenever I used to talk to my participant, right, whenever I used to say them, I would like to really thank you for giving me this opportunity. Initially, I did not understand that why is this thanking? Yes, thanking as a part that Sadhguru offered me this opportunity to teach it, but why them also? Because that is also a sadhana. So this is an opportunity for my growth only. So after understanding that, even now, the more deeper you understand, the more easier it becomes to see what Sadhguru is saying, not is not only a social thing, but it is just everything is for your growth. Everything can be for your growth.
Awesome,
Okay.
Anna. Okay.
All
Thank
right.
you.
Thank you. Thank you. Namaskar.